intentionally come and stand at the door of the classroom, and when the girls are passing by, they'll press them. Hey! Wow! Welcome back to my channel. My name is Thelma and I film about food, faith and lifestyle. Today's video, I have postponed it for so long. Like, one reason or the other, I've not been able to film it. Like, when I'm about to film, something will just happen and I'll not film the video. And I was like, see, today, we must film this video. And today I woke up and the weather is dull. Like, it's cloudy here. And I'm using natural lighting, so the video is going to be a little bit dark. Please forgive me. It's just that the video must be filmed today. So today's video, I'm going to be talking about unforgiveness, dealing with unforgiveness. And some time ago, I put on my social media, I put on my WhatsApp status and my Insta story that you guys should share with me some of your stories, like your unforgiveness stories, things people have done to you, that kind of stuff. And in this life, you see, if you are there, if you know they are doing something to somebody and it's probably going to hurt a person, stop it. Because people are hurting. People are doing things to people. Like, what is going on? People are really doing things to people. Like, if you know you are part of these people, please stop it. Stop it. Stop. So for this video, I have to purposefully wait for the day I'm in the best of moods to film it, because I don't want to get emotional with filming this video, because it is very, very, like, personal to me. You understand? If I'm not in the best of moods and I'm filming this video, I might get too emotional with it. So I'm in the best of moods today. So I want to begin by talking about how people take offenses differently. Okay, so we are all different, and your personality type can greatly affect how you would take offense, how you would take unforgiveness, how you would quickly be able to forgive somebody. Removing the Christian aspect aside, like your natural self, how fast you'll be able to respond to forgiveness, you understand? It greatly depends on your personality type. I mean, there are people that you would, like, something can be done to them, no matter how serious it is, they're like, hey! And so what? Like, they cannot kind of kill themselves. Like, people who are like that, like, they can't even take offense too seriously, and that's just them. And there are people too, the littlest of things, they will sit down, cry about it, meditate about it, think about it. Why did you do this to me? Like, why? You understand? People who will take their time to think, and it is not like they are bad. It's not like those who don't take the offense too seriously are good either. It is just different personality types, and you can't really control that, okay? But what you can control is how much you let it affect you consciously, okay? So I want to first begin by saying, when it comes to forgiveness, there are three types of people. There are those who will tell you, I'm not thinking about this, like, I've forgiven you, move on with your life, like, it's nothing, just move on. But they're thinking about it. They are so thinking about it. They are meditating upon it. They are wondering why you did that. How you did that. Why? Like, why? They are so thinking about it, but they'll be like, oh no, I think personally I fall in that category. Like, oh no, I'm not thinking about it, but I'm thinking about it. And they are the people to who will say, me, I'm forgiving you. I've so forgiven you, but I cannot forget. I won't forget. It will be in my mind, but I don't have anything against you. I've forgiven you. And that category of people too. And then there is those who will tell you to your face that, Mayo, I won't forgive you. Like, I will so not forgive you. They'll make you aware. Say, they are holding a grudge against you. So there are these three types of people when it comes to, like, God forgive us, okay? And human as we are, day in, day out, people will offend you. Like, people have offended you. People are yet to offend you. People will continue to offend you. Like, people will offend you consciously and unconsciously. People can do things that they didn't know that was going to offend you, but it offended you. People will do things too that I'm sure they know it's all they are doing, it's going to offend you, but they will still do it. Then in there, people are just going to offend you. People will cause you to live with bitterness. Like, people can do things for you for you to sit down and be like, hey, wow, you did this to me. Like, people can make you think about life and wonder that, wow, human beings. Like, I realized that there are things people will do to you. There is nothing that can make it right. Like, there are some things that you do, nothing can make it right. So sometimes mind what you are doing to people, because from the stories that people sent to me, most of them, I'm not even going to mention it at all, because I replied them in their DMs and I spoke to them about it and everything, okay? And most of the stories too, I have dissected it and digested it. And I'm just using it as like points, okay? I'm not going to say the actual story, but this one I want to share. This one was shared by a friend, and personally, I was, let me say, heartbroken to know that my friend had gone through this, okay? Because she wasn't even able to open up about it for years until, like, I asked that question and then she talked about it. So it was way back in like primary school or JHS or like basic school. Then she said let me just summarize it. They were moving classrooms, and because of that, there were a lot in one place, okay? And then the class boys had this stupid thing that they were doing. Like, when the school has closed and people are going home, they'll intentionally come and stand at the door of the classroom, and when the girls are passing by, they'll press them. Like, press them. Can you imagine? They'll intentionally come and stand at the door. So when the girls are passing, then they'll press them. So one way or the other, she never actually came into contact with that kind of situation. And they never actually got to do it to her. And then one day, her daddy came to pick her up, and he was in a hurry. And like, she didn't have a choice but just to go, because those people were determined to stay there. They were not going to leave. So she went to pass there, and they did the same thing to her. Guys, she so felt bad about it. She felt defiled. And then, like, at that time, she was a small girl. There were small boys too, but they thought they had come. They had come on top and they were doing things. It so affected her that for many years, look at the time span from basic school now to now. From that time, it was recently that she was able to forgive them. Can you imagine? And because of that incident, she was not able to relate with boys very well ever since that day, because she felt like if people that she had been in class with for like 9 years, because this was like basic school, this was so long, she felt like if people like would do that to her, then how much more some stranger guy somewhere, or somebody that she has known you for barely a few weeks or a few months, you could do worse to her. So it affected her relationship with boys so bad. And I'm sure that wherever those boys who were doing that thing, wherever they are now, they are not even thinking about it. They don't even know the harm they have caused to her. But the kind of pain they have made her go through, it took her years. Guys, it took her years. And there are things people do to you, it took take you years to forgive them. Like me, me personally, the offense, they are in stages. There are some offense that it can take you hours to forgive. There are some it can take you weeks, some months. And there are some it will take you years, together with prayers and fasting, for you to be able to forgive them. Like, sometimes human beings do some things and I still have to wonder why. Like, why would you do that? But personally, I've had my own share of people offending me. Like, if I want to start talking about people who have offended me and how they have offended me, this video will probably go like 3 hours. But I want this video to be very, very short. That is why I'm talking pretty fast and I'm not saying too many things. But I want to share this one. This is just something minor that happened back in SHS. So, you know how back in SHS, then when people are made prefects, they feel like they are on top of the world, like they can do anything they want. Yes, they are prefects, but then they feel like they can punish you, they can talk to you anyhow. Sometimes, yes, that is how some of the prefects behave. And then we got to, well, final year, okay. So, meaning the prefects were our mates. And then there was this evening, my best friend and I were talking about this prefect in our house, and she was being too mean. She was taking the whole prefectship thing like too, just being too mean with it. Like, you are prefect, you are a leader, you're supposed to like lead us to do what is right, and besides, you are our mate. So, you know, in SHS, like, it was the 4 months before to that they mostly disturbed. And even that, the way she was treated them, it was not nice. It is true that sometimes you have to be hard for the people to obey you. But then she was overdoing it. She was talking about it in the dormitory. And it wasn't just us who have noticed it, okay? Other people have noticed this too. So it was like, we're talking about it in the dorm. And this girl in the dorm was also talking about it, contributing. Then next day we realized she went out of the dormitory, so like probably to pee or something. We didn't even think about it like that. Then like 5 minutes later, this particular prefect came into the dorm with squad. You know how people, as people form squad, cliques, those things. So this girl came into the dorm, bagadine, opened the door with her squad. Come out now, sit down. Hey, me and my best friend, because we started a conversation, what else today? Like, she was taking plenty. She was going to make our life first rumble. Then, this is our mate. She was, oh god, she so promised she was going to make the rest of our stay in the school miserable. And she did. She did. And this girl who went to tell her, or went to report her, like I said, she was contributing, she was saying stuff, everything. And it's not even like we were lying or anything. We're just talking about our observations and like how she could do things better. And I was thinking when I was maybe approaching her to like talk to her about it or something. But because the girl was being mean, I think this girl, when she went to court, she was thinking about it in the sense that she wanted to gain favor with her. Prefect, so that when the prefect is being mean or punishing people or that, she'll favor her because it's like an informant or something. I don't know what she was thinking, but it was very, everybody in the dormitory was like, wow, like, are you serious? She came back to the dormitory later and she couldn't even talk to anyone in the dorm, and it was some weird. And I was even wondering that, I don't know how we would say, because you're not in the same dorm with her. You are here with us, and now you're going to report us. We are not even asking you the things. Your subconscious is pepping you. Your body is pepping you. You cannot even relate with us. Well, you are just suffering in your body. You understand? And it didn't take us long to forgive her, okay? Because it's just something minor. What I'm trying to say is that day in, day out, think about your actions. How are they going to affect somebody else? Look at the scenario that I gave you guys like this. Those boys didn't know that they were going to affect her relationship with boys for years, guys. And it took her the grace of God and then help recently to be able to forgive them. And then relate more with guy. It was explaining that was why back in school she was so laid back and seemingly mean. You understand? So sometimes people do some things, it's gonna be undone. Recently I saw something on the internet, this man had raped three small boys, three siblings. I think they were 10, 8, 10, 6, something like that. They were very young. He had raped them, not only had he raped them, he had raped them to the extent that they had tested HIV positive. I want to do something to you. God is saying, I should not say that. They will be punished. They will be punished to you. He's a God who will save you. Follow you.
Yeah, deep down in my heart, you give me joy, you give me life,
you give me joy, give me life,
you give me hope.